So hello everyone, my name is Mark and welcome to a new video on my channel. In this video I'm going to show you the best way to play with Real Madrid, in my opinion, of course. I'm going to show you the best formation, the best tactics and the best instructions, the best lineup of course. But first of all I want to thank you very much for watching. If you like the video, please drop a like underneath the video. It will really help me to grow my channel. If you didn't subscribe yet, make sure you will do that as well so you don't miss any new videos I'm posting. I'm also gonna make these videos for FIFA 20, of course. If you have to say something or wanna ask me something, drop it in the comment sections below. So we're gonna start with the formation. It's a 4-1-2-1-2 narrow. We're going to the lineup. Courtois is the goalkeeper, of course. Then we have Carvajal at the right. Varane and Ramos are the center backs, and Marcelo is the left defender. So no surprises at all, I think. Casemiro is the central defensive midfielder. Modric and Kroos are the central midfielders. Isco is the attacking midfielder. Bale and Benzema are the strikers. Then we're going to the tactics. I choose balanced with a width of 4 bars, a depth of 5 bars. To offensive style is possession with a width of 8 bars. Players in the box, 6 bars. 3 bars corners and 3 bars free kicks. So we're going to the instructions. All defenders stay back while attacking as always. When I like my left or right defender to run forward, I will trigger them to push the button myself. Then we're going to the central defensive midfielder Casemiro. Cut passing lanes, stay back while attacking and cover center. Then we go to Modric. He's just default. Same for Toni Kroos, he's just default also. Then we're going to Isco, come back on defense and free roam. As you can see here, positioning freedom is free roam, so he can do whatever he wants. We're going to Bale, stay central, get him behind. And then we go to Benzema, he is just default. And only thing I changed is come back on defense, because when I'm playing with two strikers in FIFA at this moment, I like one of them to come back and the other one to stay in front. So Benzema is the one who's coming back. Bale, with his pace, he's staying in front. It's really useful sometimes for a counter attack. Then we're going to the substitutes: Asensio, Mariano Jr., Ceballos, Navas, Odriozola and Fernandes are the substitutes. Most times I use Asensio as to replace Isco, sometimes to replace Benzema, or even sometimes to replace Marcelo when he's get tired. Mariano I didn't use that much. Junior I use a lot to replace Benzema. He's really fast, 5-star skill moves, so that's really nice to have also. And with his pace you can really use him when you are at the end of the game and need some counter attack, some speed in your attack, you can use Junior. And then we have Fernandes, Odriozola, Navas. Ceballos I used most times to replace Kroos when he gets tired. Sometimes I'm using Fernandes and to replace Casemiro. Casemiro can go to the central midfielder and Fernandes would be the central defensive midfielder. But it's only when I'm under heavy pressure and want to defend my lead, but it's not using that. I'm not using that too much. Well, that's it for the Real Madrid video. I hope you liked it. If you did, please leave a like for me underneath the video. It's really helpful for me. If you are new to my channel, didn't subscribe yet, make sure you'll do that as well. And if you have to say something or want to ask me something, drop it in the comment sections below. So this is the end of the video. Have a nice day. Bye bye.